And now, here are some highlights from my Barnes & Noble book signing in Scottsdale, Arizona. Hope you enjoy.
Don't you think? It's like, skinny dipping in the fountain of youth, what does that mean? And I have the belief and philosophy that beauty, true radiance, true joie de vivre, sex appeal, you know, whatever you want to call it, can only come from the inside out, especially after about the age of 25, 30. Right? And even, I'm sure you guys have seen, you know, I've seen stunning men and women who are 20-something who from afar, I'm like, wow. And then they open up their mouth and you go, wow. And it's just not beauty from the inside out. What really captivates, what really enlivens, what really draws exactly what we want in our life to us on every level is what's radiating from the inside out. And that's what skinny dipping in the fountain of youth is all about. So what I have done in my book is, and what I would like to do in the little bit of time we have together tonight, is to share some of my best kept secrets on how to do this, and then you guys can ask any questions that you might have about, especially MJ, I know you've already read the book, for any of you who've already read the book, and for those of you who haven't, whatever piqued your interest, I would love to answer any questions that you guys might have. So let's first talk with, from looking at all of you beautiful beings, I can tell you have what I call a divinely kissed life. It's beautiful in many ways. I can tell by your radiance, I can tell by your glow, I can just tell by your energy. And we are all energy, right? At our core, we're all energy. And yet with that, with a beautiful life in every way, we live in what's, you know, we live in a universe that is ever expanding, correct? And so if the universe is ever expanding, and if we're made up of the same stuff as the universe, if we're all energy, and energy is ever expanding, then we truly, not metaphorically, but physically and literally, have the capacity to become younger, stronger, deeper, richer, wiser, more flexible, more radiant, more beautiful, better in every single way, on every single level of our life. And I know we get busy with our lives. Our lives are full, they're rich, they're filled with people who call upon us and need us and want us, and you know, so we race around. You know, a lot of times we're racing around, I gotta rush here, I gotta drop this off, I gotta go meet my children, I gotta go get my, you know, see my parents. And sometimes it's just really great to take a breath and just center ourselves and just be like, whew. And one of the first secrets of skinny dipping in the fountain of youth is, my first chapter is choice. Because in every moment we have a choice. So we can race through our life at, you know, at warp speed, or we can take a moment and we can just breathe for a minute. And in that breath, we can listen to the, what I call the whisper of spirit, guiding us. And just, okay, call MJ or call Kathy or get in touch with Linda or turn right, turn left, go straight. Because each one of us in every area of our life, as amazing as it is looking to expand. Is that not correct? As amazing as your lives are, is there maybe one area? So let's just take a peek at us for a second. So let's see, this is our beautiful self here.
Nice long legs.
With our beautiful heart. Either that or our Dolly Partons.
Yeah.
Both work, well, except for our gentlemen. Okay, so let's put a beautiful smile on her face. So let's say we have amazing life, but maybe in the area of health, we'd like some expansion. Anybody here looking for expansion? Just a little bit of expansion in the area of health.
Yeah.
Just a little bit. Even if we're already amazing, we could still have more, right? So how about in the area of relationship? So maybe we have great relationships, but maybe we'd want just a little bit more. How about in the area maybe of weight management? We might, you know, feel great, feel strong, feel that, but there's always room to improve. So we have all these different areas. It could be love, intimate relationships, it could be career. Even if you have the most amazing career, there's always room for expansion. And especially in the area of career, when I work with clients about career, career isn't just for ourselves. What I say is in all of eternity, for all of time, there's only one you, one you, one you, one, each one of you with your divine, magnificent, unique combination of gifts to give to the world. And if we don't give those gifts, what I call the mosaic of life, or the full expression of life, isn't complete. So even though we might be really rocking in our career, there's more we could do, because there's always more we can give. So if we're touching 10 lives, you know, maybe we can touch 11, maybe we can do more. So there's always room for expansion. So maybe in financial, maybe in the area, maybe we already have a lot, but maybe, you know, let's plan a cruise this year. Let's take our family on a cruise. But in every one of these areas, and maybe there's even more, there's always room for expansion. So one of my first secrets, what I say, is small changes. Just, I'm talking small, little changes. This is the sign for changes. Equals miraculous results. And what I mean by that is if we, I'm going to give you guys an example. I'm just going to put this down. So, and when I say miraculous, I really mean miraculous. So, just a small change. So, what could a small change look like? Let's say in the area of health and weight. Let's say you're like, you know, I'm in my size 4 skinny jeans, but maybe I want to do a little better. Or maybe I want to, you know, whatever the reason, maybe I want to be a little healthier. So we're waking up in the morning and maybe we feel a little sluggish or a little bit, you know, God, I don't have as much energy as I would like to have. We can make one small change in how we wake up in the morning, and that will change the entire trajectory of our life just by how we wake up in the morning. Make sense? So let's say, and how we wake up in the morning, what I always say is, how we wake up in the morning is predicated upon how we go to sleep at night. So it really starts the night before. So let's say we want to have a great day tomorrow. We're all starting because we're here today all together celebrating and having fun. So we go home. How consciously do we get ready to go to sleep? Do we give gratitude before we fall asleep at night? Do we take just a moment to take a breath before we fall asleep at night? Do we go to sleep at a reasonable hour? Who here goes to sleep before 10 o'clock? We're in the minority. So in my book, I talk about something called juicy sleep. Anybody know what juicy sleep is? Juicy sleep is the sleep we get before midnight. And the reason it's juicy is the time when our bodies rejuvenate our sex hormones and our vitalizing hormones. So if we go to sleep, and it's, let's say we go to sleep at 8, I know, it's pretty radical, I do that. It's so pretty crazy, and I get up at 4, and I love it. So I've test-driven this whole philosophy. I read tons of articles about this because I was really interested in, for myself, I'm so interested in having the most extraordinary life imaginable. And so I go on an adventure to discover what that could look like in its most expansive area. So I started playing around. I used to be night owl. Who here's a night owl? Yes, I love it. It is insanely fun, creative, exciting being up late at night, especially if we're doing some fun things. But even if we're not, it can be very exciting, creative. And what happens is after about 10, we get a second wind, and all of a sudden it's 2 o'clock in the morning. But when we do that, when we wake up in the morning, how do we usually feel? Coffee, I'm tired, we don't feel well. So I started experimenting with, I said, okay, I'm gonna stop being a night owl. Started going to sleep at 10 p.m., which was radical for me at the time. Woke up at 6, I was like, I feel better. My workout partner happens to be a fireman who gets off of work around 4 or 5 in the morning. He says, we're going to the gym at 5. Kidding me? So I said, okay, I get 8 hours of sleep because it's 8 hours of juicy sleep. So I wake up, I go to sleep at 8, wake up at 4. And I have to tell you from firsthand experience, I feel like a million bucks. That sleep before midnight is truly revitalizing, juicy, energizing sleep. Now I'm not recommending that everybody has to do that, but if we can get closer to a 10 p.m. bedtime, you're going to feel way, way better when we wake up in the morning. I've been trying to get her to get ourselves as open, clean as possible. Then the universe can sing through us in beautiful ways. And like I said earlier, in ways that are unique to us. We all have our own passions. We all have our own, you know, desires. We all have our own gifts and talents. And they can be like, you know, like mine are very different, you know, doctor, dancer, roller skater, you know, it's like they're all very, and you know, it's like people would be like, you went from here to there to there. But when you look at it now at 57, when I look back at it, all of that is the unique combination that makes up the person that wrote the book and does what I do in my life. So it's for each one of you, all these, don't be afraid of your multi-talents, you know, as different as they are. We find ways to combine them that are unique to us, that allow us to express who we are and help other people in the process. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. And then the next chapter is move. Who here likes to exercise?
I'm working on it.
Who here doesn't like to exercise?
Perfect. Okay. Captain, gotta work on you. Coffee, sleep.
That's okay. So here's what I like to tell people about that. Exercise, like, I hate to run. I'm not built to run. I don't like it. It's not fun for me. It's just, and I have a friend who loves to run. She runs 10, 12 miles every single day.
Oh, wow.
I know. And bless her heart, she's built to run. I'm not built to run. So I could try to make myself run, but it just, why, right? I salsa dance. It is so much fun. And it's great cardio. I go out for a couple hours, you know, and it's just amazing. So I say go on an adventure to discover what ways you love to move your body, ways that turn you on, from everything from making love to exercising to, it could be dance, it could be gardening, it could be yoga, it could be whatever, but does it turn you on? Does it get you out the door, up out of bed, and excited? Because that's, so for those of you who aren't excited about exercising, look at what, you know, what is it that really excites me and turns me on? So that's the movement chapter. And also, I do speak about the menopause monster in the book. I know we have all different ages here. But menopause monster kicked my butt. So I do have a whole section on that and what to do about that. It's very helpful. I work with a physician who's been featured on CNN, who's very, very good. And so there's lots of information on that if you guys have any questions. And that's good for men as well. So for all your significant others, they lose testosterone as much as we lose, you know, all the other sex hormones. So it's important for them as well. So move, then the next chapter is love. And what I talk about with love is, how do we love ourselves first? Because to make these choices, whatever choices we decide to make, has to come from self-love. How do we love ourselves? How do we love others? How do we develop intimate, loving relationships? Because I know that's important to, you know, some people may not have their significant other. And then how do we love and express that out in the world? So that's the love chapter. Then spirit chapter, how do we tap into our essence and our spirit and express that? And then the very last chapter is community. How do we come together in a way that we love and support each other in a way that enriches all of our lives? So that's just a teeny little bit about the book for you guys. Does anybody have any questions about anything? No? Alex, go ahead.
So in the past year, I've thought a lot about self-healing. Mm-hmm. There's a magazine right there with the Wild, however you say his name.
Right.
So I just learned that Deepak Chopra has some type of center north of San Diego. Have you been there by chance?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm talking to him about teaching there. I'm speaking to them about teaching there right now.
Really?
Yeah. So it's there. So when you say self-healing, because there's wonderful aspects to self-healing, and we do have the power to do that. I mean, if you think about it, like I said earlier, we are infinite beings, the universe. We are made of the same stuff of the universe, and we have the capacity, powers beyond our wildest imagination. We have within us, if we tap into using the mind, incorporating that with self-healing techniques. Is there one in particular you're interested in knowing about, or that I could maybe help you?
I just want to know about that center, so it sounds like you're familiar with it.
I just go there
on a Friday and say, hey, can I have a tour?
You know, you have to call them to find out. You know, I don't know how they do that, but it's, but from the aspect of self-healing, there is a lot that we can do. The power of our mind and our thoughts creates everything. Everything that we see is created first in thought, and then it gets created in the physical form. So we can manifest what we don't want as easily as what we do want, just by the power of our mind. So self-healing is a very powerful thing. Yes, so So check it out.
I don't know if you don't mind me saying something about sleep. I agree with her. It's hard to go to bed before 10 o'clock. We're all going to be up after 8 o'clock tonight.
Exactly.
But, so about 10 years ago, I started working a compressed shift, you know, 4 days instead of 5 days. And I didn't compensate. So I started getting up at 4:30 in the morning instead of 6:30 in the morning. I was still going
to bed
at 11 or midnight.
Wow. Yeah, that's tough.
And right away, within, you know, I had been the same weight for 5 straight years. Within 4 months, I put on 15 pounds in 4 months.
Right.
And I thought it was because I was sitting, you know, two extra hours at a desk. Then, you know, years later, I learned it was because of sleep deprivation.
Sleep is anyone, for women under around over 30, when about 35, it is our best friend. Sleep is our best friend. You'll see it in your body, in your face, and everything. It's really, really powerful. So the more, and when we were speaking, even if you get a little extra, you know, even if you go to sleep a little bit earlier, when I speak about sleep also, I mean the people who are staying up midnight, 1 a.m., you know, consistently. And even if you're getting 8 hours of sleep, the 8 hours you sleep midnight to 8 a.m. or 1 to 9 a.m. is not the same as the sleep you get from 10 to 6.
Oh, I agree.
So that's really, and so the more we can get, like I said, you know, it's here's where we are. The more we can move towards this direction, the better off we are. But, and not, you know, it's like, you know, there are times when, I mean, like, I'm up later than that, but I'm, you know, on a regular basis, I go to sleep earlier. And what I really did learn is that the more you do that, the better you feel. I think that's really what I want to share with you guys, is the more you do it, the better you're going to feel. Did you want to say something?
This is just kind of a little bit of a comment to that. And I heard this on the radio, and I'm going to be looking for it, but on 60 Minutes, I guess about a year ago, I don't know when it was, they did some kind of sleep study on this young man who every night for like a week, they interrupted his sleep. It was about snoring, because I'm concerned about snoring and waking my husband up. And within a week, he became a diabetic.
Oh.
And then it was like, it was on 60 Minutes, and I know I'm probably like messing it up in my head, and I'm hoping I'm not giving you misinformation. Then when they stopped it, he went back to normal. So
sleep is really our best. Sleep is really our best friend. It's one of the best gifts we can give ourselves.
So my deal is the snoring, and I wake my husband up, and I'm afraid I'm turning him into a diabetic now. Because I wake him up in the middle of the night. Seriously.
You know, Beth, I have something
that's
for you
the worst
on that, okay?
Sleep.
There's a woman that I know, she's in Los Angeles, but she works with people via Skype, so remind me, I'll tell you about her. And she works with people with problems with sleeping, and also problems with the snoring.
Yeah, because
FYI.
What kind of doctor are you?
My doctor's in dentistry. I practiced for a while in a car accident. I talk about the journey in the book. A car accident retired me. And so that's when I began this whole journey of speaking and talking about health and wellness. When I turned 50, I was invited to speak at a conference. And so that really what began. Then people started asking, in fact, you were at that conference. People started asking for my book, and I literally was like, oh my God, I have to write a book. And that's when.
Carol, you knew me back then, remember? And I was just like,
oh my gosh. I mean, because you know how some people, I'm sure there's been authors here that have book signings, and I'm kind of embarrassed to say this, but I was not the person who was like, oh, I want to write a book someday. That just was never in the scope of my, or realm of my thinking. That's why one of the things I tell people is that if you can be open to the miracles of what the universe can bring you by just following your passion and your heart. I started out as a dentist, and didn't love it. I didn't, bless my father's heart, bless his heart. He's a physician. He's brilliant. I mean, if there's anything wrong with any one of you, I would give you his number and say call him, because he's one of the most brilliant medical intuitives and diagnosticians around. But his dream for me was to enjoy what he enjoyed, as opposed to seeing what I could enjoy. And so I ended up going on that path, and I literally felt like I put my ladder of life against a building, climbing to the top and looking out and going, I'm on top of the wrong building.
8 years later, after all that school and how much in debt, and I'm like, oh my gosh, what am I going to do now?
But that journey has been the best gift in my whole life, because it's endowed me with the capacity to help other people who might feel like I'm here and I want to be here. How in the world can I do that? Because no one knows that better than someone who's gone from A to B in any aspect of your life. Because I really believe we're here for such a short amount of time. Like, we're just, it's a blip on the radar screen, even though days can seem really, really long when they're tough. But we're really here for such a short amount of time, and we want to enjoy it to the fullest, as much as possible, and drink it up. I think one of the reasons I love what I wrote in my book so much, and I love what I teach, is because at every moment we have the capacity to have a regular life or a really extraordinary life. And it's just that choice that we make every time we wake up in the morning. And because we do get so busy, we get so bombarded with, you know, I mean, just turn on the TV, talk about, you know, overload. Good God, you just want to crawl back in bed. And I tell people, turn the TV off. Don't pay attention to that, because it just sucks the life out of you. Decide what it is you want to make your life into, and then go and do that. But so anyway, that's the long answer to. And I'm grateful. I'm actually grateful. It's funny, because what I teach and how I teach it is really over here, kind of on the left, not very conservative. And you know, it's funny how life works out. That doctorate has served me very well, but not in the way that you would have expected it to. Mm-hmm. So it gives me credibility when I speak at talks, and it gives me all sorts of things, but it was not the path. So we don't have to get stuck. If we make a turn that way and we go down that way, we don't have to stay there. I hear people all the time saying, I started dancing. My dream was to always dance ever since I was a little girl. I couldn't sit still. I was just, and I never, my mother wanted me to be a classic pianist, and so that's what I ended up doing. Bless her heart. And my dad wanted to be a doctor. And so by the time I was, you know, in my 20s, I was like, but I just want to dance. Like, I want to. And I thought, and I want to share this story with you guys, because it's powerful for wherever it is you want to go in your life. I literally thought I missed the boat. Like, when I was in my 30s, I was like, God, it was as if all the dancers got on the dance boat, and I missed it. And I used to say, next lifetime, I'll come back as a dancer. That's how much my soul longed to do it. And then a girlfriend of mine, one of her best friends, was an intuitive. And she looked me in the eyes one day. We went to say hi to her, and I'd never met her before or anything. She looked me in the eyes, and she said, you're a dancer. And I went, nah, I missed the boat. And then, but she, what she did was she stopped, and I stopped. I took a breath, because I knew I was in the presence of something really powerful. And she said, you're a dancer, and you will dance for the rest of your life. And in that moment, I went from being, no. Like, literally, I was like, nope, not possible. I just opened up this much to the universe to say I'm willing to be open to the possibility. And my mother will vouch for this, and my sister, in crazy synchronistic ways within a couple of months with no dance training. As a child, I was on stage dancing. I was 40. I was dancing with kids half my age and having the time of my life on film and television, dancing in shows. So I share that because whatever is in your soul that you want to do, be it, you know, whatever, be it dancing or writing a book or starting a new career or starting a new love life or whatever it could be that might feel daunting, because it felt very daunting to me. I just share that story because it's possible for all of us if we just be open to that possibility. Who has something like that? That's a little, might even be a secret in their heart. They don't even want to. You can raise your hand. But yeah, so just, you know, be open to, all we have to do is say yes to the universe, and then what happens is these invitations come in, and then we just have to be open to. Thank you so much. It was such a joy to see each one of you guys and be here and to share just a little bit of what I put all my heart, whole heart and soul into the book. So I
awesome.
It's
excited to share with all of you guys.
You're wonderful.
You're awesome.
You are awesome.
You're a rock star.
It's 3 hours of hardcore cardio. I dance one partner after the next, after the next, after the next. 3 hours has passed. I don't know how many hundreds of calories I've burned, and I've had the time of my life. That's another perfect example of the GLF factor. So what I'd like you guys to do until we meet again.